Now to a GMA health alert. A new study could make the pap smear a thing of the past. Every woman said hallelujah. More than 13,000 women will be diagnosed with cervical cancer this year, and now a massive new clinical trial finds that the HPV test is better than the traditional pap smear in detecting early signs of the disease. Dr. Jen Ashton is back. So, Jen,
good morning.
Good morning to you again. Tell us about the study and what this could really mean for
all
women.
So this appeared in the Journal of the American Medical Association. It was a big study done in Canada. They followed women over a four-year period, divided them into three groups: women who were screened using just the HPV, that's the human papillomavirus test alone, women screened with traditional liquid-based pap, and then a safety group. And what they found is that the women who were screened just with the HPV test had a lower chance of developing the precancerous lesion that we worry about progressing to cervical cancer. So again, the presence of the virus tended to trump the abnormal cells on the pap smear.
And this is eliciting a lot of response. Nicole wrote into us on Twitter asking, why isn't HPV testing standard during a pap if so much of the population has it?
Well, the good news for women listening is that for the most part in this country, it already is. Women should ask their provider if there is automatic reflex HPV testing. This is not something the doctor has to say, now I'm going to check you for HPV. It's done with the same instruments as the pap. So I just want to show people. These are the instruments we use for a traditional pap smear. Nothing scary here. The same instruments are done to do the HPV test. The pap smear looks at cells. The HPV test looks at DNA of this virus, which is sexually transmitted.
So next time we go to our OB-GYN, do we ask for an HPV test if it's more effective than the pap smear? Do we even need a pap smear?
You should ask if reflex testing is done, but here's what I want women to know. When they get screened with a pap smear, because this is not going away, we still need more long-term follow-up and data. They need to ask, when my result is back, it's not just normal or abnormal. They need to ask for the specific terminology, and then management of abnormal pap smears is based on whether or not there's HPV there, the age of the patient, and that patient's particular personal pap history.
And is there anything else that women can do to lower their risk of cervical cancer?
There is, Paula. And you know, the single greatest advance for cervical cancer, is aside from the pap smear screening, is the HPV vaccine. This is what prevents the majority of cervical cancer, which is caused by this virus. So getting vaccinated for women and men up to the age of 26, very important. And then smoking, it's bad for the whole body, but it's really bad for the cervix.
Vaccination. Great information as always.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.